G'day, Alister Christie here from LearnDelphi.tv, and in this video I have created a VCL application and just thrown a button on, and I'm just going to go set the caption, and I'm just going to throw a Unicode character in here. So I've gone and gotten this one, I'll just copy that to the clipboard using the character map application and paste that in. And if we run that, it all works fine. We can also represent characters as their numerical equivalent by appending a hash character. And that number is actually not helpful to us. What we want, this is a Unicode character table that I've picked at random from the internet, and that's the character we want. And this is the code. Like so. And if we run that, that works fine. And this works, that is basically a string character. So if we can go, like so. And I'll even just add some spaces in there to make it pretty. And run that. And there we have our Unicode character in our text using its Unicode number. Now, the interesting thing about the syntax is I can omit the pluses. And this is what I'm demonstrating this video about. It is an unusual Delphi syntax, but it's perfectly valid. And you can chain these characters together. Let's go back to the website if we wanted a number 2 as well. Obviously it's 103, so I'm just going to copy that. 3 and 4. And we can run that. And then we have our Unicode characters quite happily embedded. Now this could be useful so our file format is ANSI. If we had that Unicode character in there, that might get lost when we're loading and saving. There might be some reason you need to have an ANSI source file. But we could specify UTF-8, for instance, if we wanted to save Unicode stuff properly. But that's pretty much all I want to demonstrate in this video, is this interesting syntax where you can omit the pluses quite happily. I originally discovered this with the quite often the is line break. So we see that's hash 10, hash 13, and occasionally you come across source code that has, something like that. So carriage return and line feed. And let's comment that out for now. So obviously that hasn't put the line feed in there. That should probably have worked, but anyway. But if you have code like that, you should instead use the isLineBreak const, because of course it's cross-platform. So if we're on a POSIX system, we want, such as Android or iOS or OS 10, pretty much everything but Windows, we want the hash 10 rather than 1310. Thanks for watching to the end of this video. If you want to help support my efforts, remember, like and subscribe is always good, but you can also purchase one of my videos, which you can find at LearnDelphi. I've been doing a little bit of work on the website. It'll look a lot better in the near future, but you can check out my mega pack, which has, it's 30 something hours, this is 34 here, but it might be a little bit more than that, of video. So basically it'll take you a week full time to work your way through it all, and is quite comprehensive. That's, you can buy that in two versions. There's a download version which you get through ShareIt or through Embarcadero Academy. And although I make less money through Embarcadero Academy, I do tend to have added to this, to the mega pack over the past, and I can't really deliver new updates via the download, but they get added to the Embarcadero Academy course. So anyway, and there, of course, there are other videos. Oops, if we go back to premium content, you can buy these videos individually as well. Anyway, thanks for watching, and thanks for putting up with the sales pitch. I'll catch you in the next video.